that is one philosophy which I myself totally believe in. That what every single day is a new day. Whatever we can write, it is in our hands what we can write, how much we can write. And it applies, I mean, this is a very abstract thought, that what is writing? Writing is whatever work we do. It is not taking a pen and paper and writing. It is whatever work we do. I think as a woman, you know, I have to play every day different roles. It starts from being a wife of someone. It starts from being a mother to someone. It starts with being a daughter-in-law to someone. It starts with being a daughter to someone. But along with that, there is always some other thing to people whom you are attached to. And I always feel a woman is a very strong character. Because I have always believed it is the woman who creates things. She's the creator. So it is in her hands how to keep, whether it is the atmosphere at home, whether it is the atmosphere in the office, whether it is the atmosphere in the working place, anywhere you go. If a woman feels, wants to, she can create wonders. If you see my artwork also, it is maximum positive, bright colors. So you know, it is related to positivity. You know, you will see everywhere. Usually I don't have blacks and browns and greens. If they are used, they're just used for composition, balance, you know, symmetry, these kind of things. But usually it is bright. Because this is also something which I totally believe in, that it is positivity which always carry you forward in life. I think being human being, so it is, you know, there are problems, there are errors, there are things which are happening, there is stress, there is everything. But it is how do you deal with it? What is your attitude for it? That is what my poem is all about. And that is something which I totally believe in. God has given us a lot to thank for. Then looking at the things what we don't have. Because there are so many things. I have got such varied fields that we should always be thankful. So that poem is a collection of all the thoughts put together. Every moment, every day, the priority changes. So I don't plan out over a period of time. Like, you know, for 1 month, my priority is just going to be art. It never happens like that. Because if you don't have the adaptability, then half of the things are undone. See, it may happen that I'm in the middle of the meeting, there is something which is happening, and at the same time, I get a call from home wherein my son needs me. So I have to have prioritized that, okay, what is, I have to be with him as a mother or this thing. So I cannot say that or I am, you know, at home, I'm in my art and I get to know that something has happened to maybe one of my school children and I'm needed there. Then I think the art will take a back foot. The child will take a priority. So, you know, it is like it depends what the situation is and then the priority changes. So you have to perform all the roles at all the time. So if you are doing it, then it's a commitment. Then whatever you do, give it your 100%. So, you know, it is like, depends on the situation. What is a priority for that moment? There is a conflict of personalities, there is conflict of views at times within your own. I mean, not even with when you are talking to this thing, within your own, that whether I'm doing right or whether I'm doing this thing, whether I should be doing this, it does happen. But I'll tell you something. I always say that you have to equip yourself. And that is exactly what I do. My art is one of the biggest de-stressors. Because when I'm there, it is very different. Being with children is a big distressor. Because when you are with children, you are in a different world. It is so disconnected with everything else. And third is the morning 1 hour yoga. There is nothing what you can do. When you know that you have to do this, when you know your timetable is going to be like that, only thing what you can do is equip yourself. You cannot change the world. But yes, every human being has got the power of at least changing the atmosphere around him. I mean, at least let us work small at time and then let us think of bigger perspective. I always feel only one thing is most difficult for a person, and believe me, it is an impossibility, that you are known as a good person. It is one of the most difficult things because there are too many factors which affect you, which surround you as a person. But I feel the most important thing for a person to understand is when the person leaves this world, the person should be thought of in good terms. So it is not, and this the traces of you which remain like that, is only because of you as a person. So I think that I would consider very important, that I should be remembered as a nice human being, as a person, irrespective of whatever my field is, that I have left a mark, a positive mark in this world. You have that much of maturity to understand that every human being has got flaws. So I would put it in a nutshell that there are a lot of people who have influenced me. Everyone, maybe from my mom, my mother-in-law, to maybe my grandmother, who got married when she was in fourth standard. And after getting married and after having 9 children, she, by the time she retired at the age of 60, she was the headmistress and she had done her MA in Sanskrit. So in those times, when my grandfather was a freedom fighter also, in those times, what kind of hardships they must have faced and how she must have done. But isn't it amazing what people can achieve just with the help of strong willpower and family support? So I think, there are so many people like that. There are a lot, like even Rani Lakshmibai, a lady who carries a child and who's out over there because she is committed to some goal. So there are so many people like that. If you go into the history, then there is Anandibai Joshi, who in spite of all the odds became the first doctor. Or if you look abroad, then there are people like Mother Teresa, who leaves her own country and who comes here. These people who I'm talking about. So I would say there are a lot of them. There I have a teacher who, in spite of all the odds, who have braved everything. She has seen to it. She's a widow. She's seen to it that her children have gone abroad. They have settled. They have got scholarships. So it is, I would say, there are a lot and lot of women who inspire me. I look at them. I hear their story and I say, so lovely. They can do it. Yes, they can achieve it. So it is, I wouldn't say achievement is something which you only read in the newspaper or because that person becomes a public figure, so that person has achieved a lot. It is not like that. You have got your own personal achievements in your own personal life. And there are so many women who cross it every day. In fact, I'm very glad that such kind of project you have taken, because it definitely helps. Woman is one person who can relate to another woman. So you try to understand, a man is a detached person, a woman doesn't exist like that. A woman, you will see women, you have all these mandals all over the city, every city has got, clubs are there and mandals are there. You see women, they all will gravitate to one place, they all will sit together, they all have common topics, whether it is home, husband, children, whether it is exhibition being held, but they cannot exist as a single entity. So, I'm sure this will be your concept will go along. You see the changing trend in Nasik. There is a lot of change. In the last 5 years, there's been a massive change. Let us talk first about politics, wherein the women representation is even in the corporation, if you notice, there is, yes, because of maybe 50% representation is compulsory. But if you see all over in the second listing also line, everywhere you will find women coming out and women being out over there. Because the only thing is, I think Nasik has started changing. Let us come to that. Now, what is Nasik as a place? Nasik is something which has always been known as a pilgrimage town, okay, as a religious place. If you notice in the last 10 years, that whole scenario is changing. It is becoming an educational place. It is becoming a place where the finest of wines are coming from. So there is influx of people. Not only that, the infrastructure wise, it's a very growing city. I think now next to Mumbai, Pune, the entire growth is of Nasik. So there is being a lot of change. So the change is there. Only thing is, what happens is because of our vicinity to Mumbai, we try to connect immediately to Mumbai, or we try to relate to it. That there are so many things happening in Mumbai, why not it with us? But it's not distance which matters. We have to understand Nasik is altogether a different entity. It's a different city. So the growth of Nasik, in fact, I would say it's very good, it's very phenomenal. But what happens with us is we try to compare with a place like Mumbai. Continuously our listing is with Mumbai. Exactly what Pune was 10 years ago, 15 years ago, Nasik is in the same place. That is how, now that kind of growth which is happening there, it will be a more. With connection to women representatives, I think that scenario is changing. If you notice the number of clubs which have increased, the number of mandal which has increased, the on the political scenario also, if you see the women journalists also, in media also, everywhere you see more and more women are coming in. Only thing is, what I feel is they are not getting a face. So that I think we all can change. The most important thing is the minute a woman gets a secured atmosphere, she is going to be more and more coming forward. This scenario needs to change in our country very, very badly. Any place wherever a woman is, the minute she's insecure, she's going to take a back foot. That is the reason why I think our country needs to have some more stronger legal action being taken. What is happening is, there is no fear for law. It's for a woman. Always, always, the family is going to be at the forefront. And then she considers herself. See, this is the, I mean, this is the psychology, this is the way a woman is made. That she's always going to put her family in the front. Wherever she's not secured, she takes a back step. Now, we need to together, need to change this. Give them a safe and a secured atmosphere. Allow them to come out. Second thing is, we have to see to it that, in fact, I am one person, I would make it this thing. I would really like to appeal to the government, to the central government, that please make it mandatory that every single girl child should know how to have self-defense classes. She should know how to take care of herself. Very important it is. I mean, if it is made compulsory, if it is put into schools, colleges, everywhere, it's a part of your education. I think that is what is very important. Third thing, along with security, is very important is education. Education in a woman will change things. She sees to it that her education is not just benefited to herself, that education benefits her family. And very important thing, I think, is vocational guidance. Because our education is in such a way that there are no skills. So how does, because you have to relate education to earning. This is the reason why I always say women should know something. And a woman, believe me, even if she is a housewife, she will be doing something. She does something, she operates from home, she does something. Because that helps the family. See, you have to understand a woman properly, her entire life revolves around the family. Like I said, she cannot exist in a single listing. She's not a single entity. She has to be around people and her own people. So the attachment is so strong. In fact, more and more people women start coming up, the attachment, the bonding what they have is so strong. They start having their own group, which is a huge force. It starts from the government to like the macro level, make them so self-sufficient. Then only we can have this thing that we can mobilize them, we can allow them to come out, we can give them the freedom of speech, give them the freedom of expression, give them the freedom of thought, which is most important. And you see where a woman will go to. You see any household. See, today also, if I am able to sit over here and if I am able to perform so many roles at one time, I think the entire credit goes to my husband for giving me the platform. The credit goes to my family for being always there for me. The credit goes to my team who always help me. Woman is, you have to give her that kind of freedom. I think Navratri is all about energy and power. But power not in the sense of it is spiritual power. So I would associate it with Navratri is one of my very favorite. that it is all about all the goddesses. So the most important thing is you can relate. As a woman, that is very inspiring. And the energy which is associated with Navratri is tremendous. Navratri is all about energy. And energy which again symbolic of women. So with Durga. See, first of all, like I said, Samrat Group is coming up with a fabulous concept. See, let us understand the concept, let us understand the root, and then we go to the listening. As far as I know, with Samrat Group also, the inspiration for the entire Samrat Group is also lady. If I am not wrong, it is Mr. Sujay Gupta's mom who was the inspiration for him to start it off. And even Mrs. Shweta Gupta is also a very integral part of the whole system over there. So it means that they are not just someone who preach things. They are into doing it and setting exceptionally good example in front of the society. Second thing, I think the way Samrat Group is taking, I mean, it is the way it is forging ahead. It is a very marvelous thing, and they are thinking in terms of philanthropy, to giving back to the society from where we come from. That it again is a fabulous gesture. With regards to women empowerment, I think as it is, you people are doing a lot. If I'm not wrong, you are into education, you are into so many other things also. But there is one thing what I can suggest is that is something which I really believe in, is again the vocational for women. You know, starting things wherein it can be associated with the government, vocational training institutes, and giving vocational guidance to girls. Many of our girls before entering into marriage are aware about what legally they are entitled to. After becoming someone's wife also, or going in a new home, what are their legal rights? Are they aware of that? No. Level of the person, I think it's a appeal of mine to a woman that many a times we are given the opportunity. Grab it. Life is too short for regrets. And what I feel is there will be errors, there will be pitfalls, everything is going to happen. But it is going to be either ways everywhere. I mean, it's not going to happen that if you stay at home and there are going to be no errors. Step out of your house. If you get an opportunity, simply forge ahead. There are a lot of people, I feel a lot of times opportunities do come across to women, but they simply don't take it because of a fear. There is some kind of a fear, there is some kind of an insecurity. So if everything is for you, if everything is according to your thing, just go ahead. I think that itself will help. And it's not necessary that you have to achieve. Just going on to the moon is a big achievement. There are small achievements every single day, every single hour, every single minute, you as a woman can do. So break free of the comfort zone which we make around ourselves.